So in the class, as a part of number theory, I am going to discuss certain conceptual problems to understand division algorithm and divisibility rules. Okay, I will handle few problems now which will give you a clarity conceptually as well as in a problematic approach. Okay, so on division algorithm and divisibility rules, I have three problems here. I marked like this 1, 2, 3. First of all, I am going to solve the first problem, then 2 and 3. See, just read out this particular problem. The integers 34,041 and 32,506, 34041 and 32506, when divided by a 3-digit integer n, leaves the same remainder. See, leaves the same remainder. Then we need to find out the value of n. I think you all familiar with the statement of division algorithm. We all very familiar with the division and division algorithm. Division algorithm means when you divide a number A with another number B, for sure there exists Q and certain remainder R. We know that we call this A as dividend, B as divisor, this Q is quotient and R is remainder. See, if you have any division like this, dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder, we will express this division as a statement like this: A is equals to BQ plus R, for this remainder should be less than or equals to divisor. Okay, less than divisor, not equals to. So statement of division algorithm is dividend A is equals to divisor B into quotient Q plus remainder. We all are familiar with this particular idea. So now I am going to use this idea to find the value of n. See, once again read out the question. I have two integers 34,041 as well 32,506. And we are going to divide these two integers by a 3-digit integer n, by a 3-digit number n, and which leaves the same remainder. What is the value of n? Okay, so now you just look here. See, the first number is 34,041. When we are dividing this 34,041 by a 3-digit integer n, okay, n, we don't know n and we are going to find that n. When you divide this 34,041 by a 3-digit integer n, it leaves some remainder. You just say the remainder as R. And as per this problem, if you divide the other number, what is the other number? 32,506. If you divide that other number 32,506 again with n, see, this time again it leaves the same remainder R. Actually, as per the problem, we have two division statements, right? First number when divided by n leaves remainder R. The same is second number when divided by n leaves same remainder R. Okay, see, just first of all, you just use the statement of division algorithm for the first division as well as for the second division. Just have a look what will happen. For the first division, if you use dividend 34,041 is equals to divisor n into quotient. What is quotient here? Since we don't know about quotient in first division as well as in second division, you just consider here that quotient as Q1 and here that quotient as Q2. Then dividend is equals to divisor into quotient Q1 plus remainder R from first division as well as from the second one. Now the number is 32,506 and in this case n into Q2 plus R. Our intention is to find the value of n. We don't need this R as well as this Q. You just go with the subtraction here. If you do subtraction, what will happen? Just have a look. See, 32,506 and this is 34,041. I am just subtracting like this. Okay, 6 minus 1 is 5, so 0. So 10 minus 4 is 6, 4 minus 0. Okay. Just a minute. This is 32,506, right? So we need to subtract. So greater number minus the smaller. So 1, 11 minus 6 is 5, 3 minus 0 is 3, and then here 0, right? 10 minus 5 is 5, 33 minus 2, 1. 1535 is equals to nq1 minus nq2. We are subtracting. So n times of q1 minus q2 plus r minus r is 0. Just have a look. At the end, what we have? 1535 is equals to n into q minus q2. N into q minus q2 means n into some number, right? And we need to identify a 3-digit number, 3-digit integer for the value of n. That in a sense, you just look here, we need to split this 1535 as a product of two numbers. Among those two, one is a 3-digit integer and the other one, you just leave it, no problem. For that, you just go with the splitting or prime factorization of this 1535. I am just doing here for your sake. So, 1535. Okay? So, 5, 3 is 15 and 5 sevens is 35. 5 into 307. So, it is easy to write this 1535 as 307 into 5, and that value of n, a 3-digit integer value of n is 307 at the end. Our answer for this problem is 307. If you are familiar with this particular model, see, in examination, there is a chance to write directly this particular step. What is that? Difference of these two. What is the difference? 1535 is equals to n into some number. There is a chance to write this step directly if you are familiar with this model. And the idea behind the generation of this line is just based on the statement of division algorithm. So, division algorithm, and then use the division algorithm to generate this particular idea. From there, we get that n value as 307. That's our answer, right? Have a look. So, in first problem, we learnt about the statement of division algorithm and a simple application of that division algorithm. And now, using that dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder, we will generate different properties on remainders and different ideas to find out the remainders. First, suppose, if I have a number n1, see, you just say, if I have a number n1, and if this particular number is divided by some, you just take some b, and the remainder is r1. And if the same, if I have another number n2, and if it is divided by the same divisor, and in this case the remainder is r2, you just have a look. I have these two, if I have these two in my hands, when the number n1 is divided by divisor b, remainder is r1. And another number n2, when divided by b, it leaves remainder r2. From there, I will mention, see, if what is the remainder, if the product n1 into n2 is divided by b, we need to find out the remainder. See, then the remainder obtained by dividing this product with b is simply nothing but remainder obtained from this product r1 and r2. See, we need to find out this particular remainder, right? Remainder when this product is divided by b. This particular question mark value is simply nothing but when you divide r1 and r2 with b, you will get some remainder r, right? This r is simply nothing but our question mark. Okay, so finding remainder by multiplying two different numbers with the same divisor is simply nothing but finding remainders individually, and at the end we need to find out the remainder. Okay, once again I will tell you. Okay, if I have three different numbers, n1 when divided by b, remainder is r1, n2 when divided by b, remainder is r2, n3 when divided by b, remainder is r3. In this case, if you divide the product n1, n2, n3 with b, and we need to find out the remainder, then in this case this question mark is again nothing but r, for that r is nothing but the remainder obtained by dividing the product r1, r2, r3 with b. That r is our required answer. So we use this particular idea, very useful idea, in finding remainders, okay, of product of certain numbers. So this second problem is just an application of this particular property on remainders. I am just trying to use this, okay. You just have a look. I am arranging this particular property. So I have that number n. See, everything you need to note, okay. See, you need to mention this property also along with this problem. Then only you will see, then only your notes will be useful further, okay. You just have a look. N is equals to 1421, 1423, 1425, the product of these three. What is the remainder when this n is divided by 12? We need to find out the remainder when this n is divided by 12. First of all, you just try to find out the remainder when this 1421 divided by 12. And then remainder obtained when this 1423 is divided by 12. And then find the remainder when this 1425 divided by 12. At the end, we will get the value of the remainder obtained when n is divided by 12. See, first of all, when this 1421 divided by 12, what is the remainder value? See, you just check here if you need 1421 and we are dividing with 12. 12 ones is 12. We have 221. See, and then what we need to use? Again, 12 ones is 12, right? Okay. And this time I have 10 and 1. 1 out 1. So 12 8s is 96. And when you subtract, 101 minus 96 is 5. Okay. So when you divide this 1421 by 12, you will get 5 as remainder. When you divide this 1423, see 1421 and 1423, there is an increment of 2. In the same way, you will get remainder this time 7. And 1425, there is an increment of 2. This time, when you divide this 1425 with 12, you just check, you will get your remainder as 9. So at the end, see individually, the remainders are 5, 7 and 9. And finally, we need to find out the remainder when n is divided by 12. Okay. So I am just explaining everything with concept. Okay. So our target is to find the remainder when this n is divided by 12. This question mark is we need to find. So as we discussed, this question mark value is nothing but remainder r. And this r is nothing but by dividing the product 5 into 7 into 9 with 12. This is what we need to find, that r is our answer at the end. So you just check it. So 5 into 7 into 9. Okay. So we have another way also. Instead of multiplying this 5 into 7 into 9, what I do is, I just multiply first of all these two numbers, 5 into 7, and what it is? 35. When you divide this 35 with 12, what you will get? 12 2's is 24, 6 5's is 11. 11 is your answer. See, when you divide this 35 with 12, 11 is your answer. Then to find the final remainder r, use this product 11 and 9. So instead of if you divide 5 into 7 into 9 with 12, you will get some remainder. That remainder is also equals to the remainder obtained by dividing 11 into 9 with 12. See, 11 into 9 is 99. And 12 8's is 96 and your answer is 3. At the end, the question mark value and the remainder value is 3. You just have a look. This is the way to find the remainder when this particular product is divided by 12. See, from this total discussion, you need to maintain a clarity here. See, if you divide product of these three numbers with 12, you will get 3 as the remainder. If you divide product of these three numbers with 12, you will get 3 as the remainder. If you divide product of these two numbers with 12, again you will get 3 as the remainder. So instead of multiplying these three and dividing with 12, we are just using product of these three. And again, instead of multiplying these three, I am just using this idea, and then I divided the product of 11 and 9 with 12. At the end, our answer for the problem is 3. Okay. This is the way of finding the remainder obtained by dividing a given product of numbers. Have a look, and then I will handle first problem. See, every problem gives you certain conceptual idea along with the application approach. Okay. So the next problem, third one we need to solve. See, we are very familiar with dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. we did many problems based on dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. So okay, using those concepts, see, here we are learning the way of solving different advanced level problems. You may call these problems as level 2 or level 3. Usually you will face these type of questions in different competitions, and at that time we need to solve these questions with the help of our known concept in this way. Okay, see, I am not giving direct shortcuts, but I am giving you the conceptual approach along with the direct shortcut. Okay, see, if you have a look, n is equals to 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial plus and so on 100 factorial, then remainder when n is divided by 168. Okay, see, here for each and every problem I am just mentioning one concept. Okay, see, for the first problem I mentioned you concept 1. See, you just mention everything like that. Okay, concept 1. For first problem, I just mentioned you concept 1. See, which is dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Whereas for the second problem, I just mentioned you concept 2, which gives that remainder obtained by dividing n1 and n2 is nothing but remainder obtained by dividing r1 and r2. Okay, that's concept 2, which I mentioned in the second problem. Now here for this problem, we need two conceptual ideas. Concept 3 is about factorial, I will mention, and concept 4 is about the remainder. Okay, anything, one concept is about the remainder and the other concept is about the factorial. First of all, what you say about the remainder concept? See, if you divide a number n1 with b, you will get some remainder r1. And if you divide a number n2 with b and the remainder is r2, then in this case, if you divide sum of n1 and n2 with b, you will get certain remainder, right? That remainder you need to find. That remainder is simply nothing but remainder obtained by dividing r1 and r2 with b. And finally, this particular remainder r is our question mark. See, there is a chance to extend this idea for more than two numbers, and we have a chance to extend this idea for subtraction also. Not only for addition, we have a chance to extend it for subtraction also. See, what I am saying is n1 when divided by b gives r1, n2 when divided by b gives r2, and in the same way, for suppose if you have n3 when divided by b, if it gives remainder r3, okay, then if anybody asks you to find the remainder obtained by dividing n1 plus n2 minus n3 with b, we need to find out this answer. And this answer is simply nothing but we need to find out r1, r2 and r3. This r1, r2, r3 are the remainders obtained by dividing these three numbers with b. You just divide r1 plus r2 minus r3 with b and you will get some remainder r. That r is your answer at the end. Okay, see, given numbers are usually n1, n2, n3 as per the problem. And r1, r2, r3 are the remainders obtained by dividing these numbers separately with the divisor. At the end, if they ask you to find the remainder by dividing the product or by dividing the summation, then we will use this idea of finding remainder. Okay? Right. You just take it as concept 3. Okay? Concept 3 is useful to find the remainder obtained by dividing sum of numbers. Okay? Right. Concept 4 is about factorial. I think you all familiar with the idea of factorial. Okay? N factorial or n factorial. What it is? Factorial. Factorial of n. Usually notated by n factorial or n factorial. Which is simply nothing but the product of what? Consecutive naturals up to n. Okay? I will give you some number. For suppose, what is the 7 factorial? Is simply nothing but 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 is 7 factorial. If anybody asks you to find 100 factorial, you need to multiply 100 into 99 into and so on into up to 1. In the same way, what you say about 4 factorial? 4 factorial is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 and that value is 24. So likewise, we will find factorials, and at the definition of factorial, 0 factorial is mentioned as 1. Okay, so this is the idea on factorials. And concept 3 is about finding remainder by dividing the sum of different numbers with the common divisor. Okay, because divisor is same, right? And concept 2 and concept 1 are cleared at first two problems. Use these two concepts to solve this problem now. Just try a minute and then I will solve this. So just look at the board. I am going to solve this particular problem. As I mentioned you in concept 3, finding remainder when you divide sum of all these numbers with 168, sum of different numbers with a divisor is simply nothing but finding remainders individually. See, what I am going to say is, you just have a look. What is this given number? That given number is 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 4 factorial plus 5 factorial, 6 factorial, 7 factorial, 8 factorial, plus some otherwise, okay. Just I am just giving you some numbers here. 9 factorial plus and so on up to 100 factorial. We need to find out the remainder when this particular summation is divided by 168. That's what we need to do. Okay. See, as I mentioned to you in concept 3, finding remainder by dividing this summation is simply nothing but finding remainders individually and then add all those remainders. At the end, you need to find the remainder obtained by dividing the sum of remainders with this 168. See, if I did this problem, then it gives you much clarity. See, in the summation, first term is 1 factorial, which is 1. When you divide this 1 factorial 1 with 168, the remainder is 1. I am just mentioning the remainders here, okay? And 2 factorial is 2. 2 factorial is 2 into 1, which is 2. When you divide with 168, your answer is 2. 3 factorial is 6 and the remainder is 6, okay? If you divide 6 with 168, right? See, 4 factorial. 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 is 24. Divide that 24 with 168. 24 itself is the remainder. And this 5 factorial, and which is what? 120. So 120 itself is the remainder, because 120 is a smaller number than 168. Then this 6 factorial. 6 factorial is what? 6 factorial is 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Then that means 120 into 6 actually, which is 720. And when you divide that 720 with 168, what is the remainder? We need to find out that. Okay. And before going to find out the remainders further, I am just thinking about this 168 for a while. You just think about 168. 168 is a combination of 8 and 21s, right? If there is 8 and 21 in the product of a number, then that is 168 multiple. So it leaves remainder 0. Okay. You just see, leave this 6 factorial for some time and then think about 7 factorial. 7 factorial in the sense, I am just mentioning here, 7 factorial means 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 7 is included here. 4 into 2 is included here. Okay, no. Yeah, I need what? 21 and 8, right? 7 and 3 is 21. 4 and 2 is 8. So 21 into 8 into something. So this 7 factorial is clearly multiple of 168. When you divide that multiple of 168 with 168, it leaves what? It leaves remainder 0. Then 8 factorial. 8 factorial means 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Again, this is the number. There we have 21 and 8. That means this is again a multiple of 168. So when you divide this 8 factorial with 168, it gives remainder 0. When you divide 9 factorial with 168, it gives remainder 0. Because 9 factorial means 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. In this product, if you observe, sure you have 21 and 8. So this is again leaves remainder 0 when you divide with 168. Likewise, if you divide every number after this 9 factorial, every number leaves you remainder 0 when divided by 168. Okay. So our task is to find the remainder when this total number is divided by 168. After this 7 factorial, all these remainders are 0. So you need to pay attention on these numbers. And 6 factorial, I am just mentioning the total number 720. Total number is 720 instead of mentioning the remainder. Okay. So now, since all those numbers are zeros, you just pay attention on these numbers. And since plus is included between these numbers, you need to add. 720, 120, 24, 6, 2 and 1. You just add all these things, okay? 6 fours is 10, 6 plus 4 is 10 and 3, 13. And coming to here, see 6, 1, 7, okay? 2, 2, 2, 6, 1, 7 and this is 8, 873. So we need to find out the remainder uptime by dividing this 873 with 168. Try to find it now. If you find that particular value and that's your answer at the end. Okay, so how to solve this? We just have a look. 168, 168 twos, 168 threes and then 168 fives. Can I go with 168 fives? 168 5s, 5 8 is 40, 5 6 is 30 and 4, 34 and then 8 40. So 168 5s is 8 40 and it leaves you what? 33 as the answer, as the remainder. So the remainder uptime by dividing the total summation with 168, your answer at the end is 33. Okay, have a look. This is the way of solving that particular problem. So, look at the board, next problem. A certain number 1 divided by 899 leaves 63. And we need to find out the remainder when the same number is divided by 29. See, as per that problem, let that particular number as n. If that number is n, as the statement says, if you divide that particular number with 899, it leaves remainder 63. And the question is also saying that if you divide the same number means same n we need to use. If you divide the same number with what? With 29. With 29, it leaves remainder some question mark. That remainder we need to find. See, the problem is very logical. You just apply concept 1. What is concept 1? Dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. For these two problems, for first problem, if you apply n is equals to right divisor 899 into quotient, see, since you don't know it, just take it as some q plus remainder 63. If you apply same concept for this second division, then you will get that n is equals to 29 into something plus that question mark we need to find. Dividend is equals to divisor into unknown quotient plus remainder. See, now we know this and we need to find this question mark. So you just try to convert this first statement into the second statement. For that we need, instead of 899, we need 29 at that position. So you just try to rewrite this 899 as a product of 29 with some other number. For that, we need to divide this 899 with 29. This is actually a rough work. 899 when divided with 29, what will happen? You just try to divide. Okay. 899 with 29. 29 ones, 29 twos, 29 threes. Okay, just check it. What is 29 threes? I think so. 29 threes is, okay, 60 and 27, 87. Again, you have 29 ones. So, that is 0. So, 899 is 29 into 31. So, now what I wrote is, see, you just take this as equation 1. From that equation, we have n is equals to 899 into q plus 63. Okay? What I do is now, n is equals to this 899 as 29 into 31 into q plus that 63 is again a number more than 29. So I need to rewrite that 63 also in terms of 29. So what I do is 63 is nothing but 29 twos is 58 plus 5. Is it right? Okay. So now n is equals to, you just pick out 29 and in that bracket you will have to be 39 q plus 2 plus 5. So this is quotient part of the second division and 5 is question mark and which is the required remainder. See, actually, this is the known division, and this is completely unknown part of division. We need to get that unknown from this known. So you just start with this known statement and then express everything in terms of 23. So finally we have n is equals to 29 into something plus 5. When you compare this with this unknown statement, you just get that remainder as 5 at the end. So this is another application of division algorithm. Have a look. And these are four different problems which helps you make stronger related to the division algorithm. Okay. And the next class I will give you different problems based on divisibility rules and the way of finding remainders using divisibility rules. That's for today's class. Thank you.